technology is also moving at such a pace that politics and policies aren't necessarily keeping up with it.
There's some great initiatives being done nationally by some great people.
Including you guys at Empiric, and I'm going to ask you that in a second. NextTech Girls is an initiative powered by Empiric. Rather than me tell everyone what it's all about, tell us what you guys do and what drove you to help create this.
So NextTech Girls is an initiative really around inspiring more girls to become women in tech. The reason that we did that was just from client feedback of the challenge of finding females within different sort of strands of tech. We thought, well, what could we do that would utilise our skills and experience in the most material way without duplicating efforts of others?
Right.
So work experience seemed to be a real strong area for us to actually sort of have an involvement.
And in the weeks that they have a chance to kind of almost embed themselves within an organisation, they get a first-hand understanding of its ways of working. Ellie, I'd love to hear your thoughts as, of course, an organisation that has been a part of NextTech Girls. What's that experience been like?
Yeah, so what we tend to do is on the first day we sit down with them. They might not necessarily have an interest in a technology career, so it's always good, I think, to start finding out what do they know about tech. And the amount of times they've come and said to me, well, I can code in this language, I've built a computer game, you know, I sit there and I'm like, you're so much better than I am. But it's really interesting hearing some of those stories.
And then, presumably some come in not having necessarily had any coding experience as well.
Yeah,
right.
Some
but
don't.
It's just they're curious about it and they want to get a sense of what it might be like.
Absolutely.
Okay, got it.
And so then you'll say, you know, what are you thinking of studying? Mm. And, it, you know, it's accountants, it's doctors, it's, you know, those sort of maybe more traditional careers.
But not computer science
but
necessarily.
But not computer science. Yeah. We had a couple of girls come in and they were interested in going into medicine. And I was like, well, we can show you what we do with medicine because technology actually really does influence that field. So let's sort of see how the two can marry up. And they spent a day and they were sort of designing what an outpatient system could be like on a digital experience. And what's so beneficial for us as an organisation as well is the way they use technology is different to the way I use technology, which is the
it's
way
very
which
unique
is different.
To each of us,
so you know, it really does help us shape strategies, but also just get a completely different insight. And it's great to see them get so excited to see they can't, you know, technology isn't a pigeonhole. You can work in so many industries.
Exactly.
And it underpins so much of what we do
now. And then presumably with NextTech Girls, the aim perhaps is to influence some positive outcomes from this to say, well, perhaps you're coming in, you didn't have a clear view of what it might feel like to work firsthand.
Yeah.
And actually some young girls I know will say, oh, it's very male dominated, isn't it? And that's daunting. And I'm thinking, well, I'd love for more of you to get in there to help change that.
Yeah.
And so there are some kind of myths or, you know, stereotypes that we need to debunk in order to make it feel more accessible. Would you say that's right, Steve?
Yeah, no, definitely. And the way that we're kind of catering for that is that when the girls apply, they get to rank how technical they are at the minute.
Right.
So we then will make the placement of, we'll have some girls that might say they're an explorer, and they're not really into tech at the minute, but they're just interested.
Yeah.
So then we'll place them with a company that's giving perhaps a bit more of a holistic overview of what tech is.
Brilliant.
Whereas then we've got girls come forward and say they're coding in their spare time. You know, so actually, we can place them with a company that's going to give them an experience that might be deep in the technical team and have them coding for the week.
Yeah.
As Ellie said, you know, actually forming strategy around or having insights into a strategy from consumers of today / tomorrow.
Yeah.
I always say that at this age, there's three key things about you know, the girls that are going on the work experiences. They're more digitally native than we are. They've got opinions they're not shy of sharing, and they've got ideas that are not bound by what's possible. They will just simply say, have you thought of doing that?
Mm.
And we've had, you know, we had girls at the Department for Work and Pensions in a design workshop, and one of the girls actually did that. She was 17. She stood up and she said, have you thought of doing this? And then the notepads went scribbling, and they took her idea into further service design exploration.
Wow.
We've got companies that are seeing, well, you know, some of the banking clients are seeing, well, hang on a minute, we've got a web app. Can you test it for us, essentially, or be involved in testing?
Yeah.
And this isn't about getting free labour or anything on those lines, because the reality is it's you can explain that is a role. There's a job out there that actually will test things to breaking point and gather the feedback to make it better.
Yeah.
So Yeah, and this is the great thing about having it, that the companies are then forming those experiences to say, well, yeah, here's an experience. The company can get some value from it. The girls get a great experience. It ticks a lot of boxes in that sense of, but not through being a box ticking exercise.
Well, exactly. It does it by default in terms of the way the initiative is structured. It just so happens quite organically, which I think is a really great place to be. So, Ellie, Atos having now been involved with NextTech Girls, I wonder if you have some takeaways or tips. Let's try a couple of them for other organizations or companies that are looking to get involved and host some of these talented young women.
Yeah, so I think three things that have made ours particularly successful is one, engaging with them before they come to the company. So I find it really useful to ask them what are their interests before they come along, because it means we can then shape their experience to something that they are interested in. Secondly is, treat them like employees. They, really want to get involved. They want to, listen and get stuck into things. Walking around the office and that sort of thing. They're just like other employees.
And give their opinion enough weight and gravitas.
Absolutely.
Rather than, it's just a sweet young girl that's come in to do a work X, which sometimes people can come up against.
Absolutely. I mean, making sure everyone in the room has a voice. Mm. I mean, people should be doing that as a given, really, anyway, in a meeting. Yeah. But absolutely, don't exclude them because they're a work experience student. They've got some fantastic ideas. Mm-hmm. And then finally, something that's worked particularly for us is moving them around the organisation. So, they don't necessarily have a huge experience in the working world, let alone in the tech world. So having the ability to see how different areas of an organisation work, but also just how an organisation works, is fantastic insight for them. And I think they've really helped to embed what we've got at Atos with NextTech Girls.
Mm. And Steve, with NextTech Girls, anything you can share with us about where you want to take this perhaps in the next year or two?
Yeah, so we've placed over 700 girls now to date, and the volume's increasing. So, big aspiration is we had visions to get to 5,000 girls placed, and we still want to achieve that. But what we're looking at now is we're investigating about making an app to have it that we can actually get the girls more involved, have it as well that we can hopefully retain more contact with them, because the challenge we have is that we're often engaging with girls whilst they're at school via their school email address. So it's that kind of drop-off element. What we want to do is kind of create this ecosystem where we can bring them in, have them have a great experience. We've got a number of girls that are coming back and saying, can we go on another one?
Oh, wow.
So we're then looking to have a platform that we could perhaps have it that there could be more things that could be offered to the girls to then have it that...
A continuity.
Perhaps there's some training providers that want to offer to do things or a mentoring scheme that can then overlay on this.
Brilliant. Guys, thank you so much for being in conversation with me. Well, you heard it here first. We're talking about shaping and creating the makers of tomorrow and changing the gender parity in the tech industry, which isn't an easy task. But with schemes like NextTech Girls and organizations that are willing to really get stuck in and get involved with that, I think we could really move the needle on it. Thank you for watching.